Good morning, students. Myself, Dr. Niranjan Shah, Assistant Professor, TC College, Baramati. First of all, I would like to welcome all of you in part 2, semester 3. In this semester, I am going to teach you a special paper which called Specialized Areas in Auditing. This is a 6th paper of your specialization. Let's we discuss the syllabus of semester 3. This is a revised syllabus from June 2020. This is the first unit named Audit of Banks. In this unit, we will discuss or we will learn about 4 major important points and 5th report point. Point 1, which is related to the silent features of enactments affecting bank. It means that the bank is a unit which is special unit. Second one, bank audit approaches as well as steps in bank audit. In this unit, we will discuss or we will learn that checking of assets and liabilities. Next one, scrutiny of profit and loss account items. These 2 items are verified or checked by an auditor. In this topic, we will discuss about the how to verify the assets and liabilities or how the scrutiny the items related to profits or losses or incomes as well as expenses. Finally, the last and most important point is a audit report of the bank. This is the first unit. Let's we discuss about the second unit. Unit 2 is related to the audit of specialized units. This is a unique topic. In this topic, we will discuss 5 important special units and the features of that special unit according to the audit. In this topic, we will discuss how the audit procedure is followed by the auditor while auditing these special units. For this purpose, we must know the features of that particular specialized units. In this topic, we will discuss about the special features of audit of educational institutions, audit of hotels, audit of clubs, audit of hospitals, and the audit of charitable trust. Next one, this is the 3rd unit, which is special, most important in this scenario. The topic name is audit of cooperative society. In this unit, we will discuss another 5 points. The first point is provision of Maharashtra State Cooperative Society Act 2013, which is latest amendment we will study in this point. Next one, we will discuss or learn about the Multi-State Cooperative Societies Act 2002. Third one, special features of audit of cooperative societies. Fourth one, audit of various types of cooperative societies. In this point, we will discuss or learn about only 4 major cooperative types of societies. First of all, we will discuss about the cooperative consumer stores, salary earners cooperative society, कोऑपरेटिव हाउसिंग सोसाइटी, अर्बन कोऑपरेटिव क्रेडिट सोसाइटी. स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट वी विल डिस्कस इन दिस टॉपिक. दीज कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज आर रिलेटेड टू अवर डे टू डे लाइफ. एंड लास्ट बट नॉट द लीस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज रिपोर्ट. एवरी ऑडिट हैज अ लास्ट एंड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज द रिपोर्ट. सो द कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज ऑडिट रिपोर्ट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट अकॉर्डिंग टू द कोऑपरेटिव मेंबर्स. Therefore, we will discuss about the audit report format and what are the provisions of audit report for cooperative society. Next one, we will discuss about the unit 4, government system audit. This is the last unit of this semester. In this unit, we will discuss about the funds maintained by government for meeting expenditures and receipts. In this unit, we will discuss about the funds provided by government, accounting of funds, and the expenses or receipts of the funds. Second point is related to structure of financial administration in India. In this point, we will discuss about the government financial structure and which is administered in a day-to-day life. Next one, objectives of government audit. Fourth one, role of Controller and Auditor General of India. This is the major and highest position of an auditor. This is a central government audit. In this point, we will discuss about the Controller and Auditor General of India, means CAG. CAG means what? What are the provisions of CAG? What are the roles of CAG? Next point, audit of receipts, expenditures, and sanctions. Sanctions means grants provided by central government as well as state government. What are the audit features and what are the books of accounts are maintained by the government institutions, government agencies, government organizations, government NGOs, etc. Next, we will discuss about the Public Account Committee. This is the one of the feature of audit. In this topic, we will discuss about the Public Account Committee. What are the features of Public Account Committee? What are the formation of Public Account Committee? What are the committee members' role? And last one, audit of public sector undertakings, audit of local bodies. It means we can discuss about the audit of municipal corporation, cantonment board, gram panchayat, panchayat samiti, etc. These all units are very important according to the our day-to-day life. These are the recommended books which you can follow for the study of these four units. You can use all these books for the preparation of your notes. Next, we will discuss about the assessment and exam pattern of our semester 3rd. There are two major important contents we will discuss about later. First, internal assessment, and next one, external assessment. Internal assessment consisted of 40 marks and external assessment consisted of 60 marks. Overall 100 marks are there. Internal assessment, that is 40 marks assessment, is related to internal test, presentation, field work, assignment, lab practical, assigning internship to the students, out of which we can follow as as early as possible, we can discuss or we can go through the assignments or internal test. Finally, the college has conducted an exam related to 60 marks. Thank you.